Hello and welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add a sound file to that of your player or character. So first of all, what you need is a sound file. And you want your sound file to be in a WAV format, otherwise it's not going to work. GDevelop only works with WAV files. So if you don't have a sound file, you don't need to worry. I'm going to leave a link in my description. You can just click on that link, download the files for this project and try it out. So in order to get this done, you have to get into your events, and right here in my events I have my player is in collision with the coin. This is what prompts the triggering of that of my sound. Hello. So you can create something like this, which is a main event, and then add a sub event. I'm going to click on this to add a sub event. And then I'm going to drag it upwards a little bit. So once I have it in place, I'm going to click on add condition, and then I'm going to type in my search trigger. So I'll click on trigger once while true and click on OK. So what trigger once does is allows your sound to be triggered only once. Without it, your sound is going to play multiple times, even if you collide with a coin only once. So I'm going to add my sound, I'll click on add action, and then I'll get to audio and click on play a sound. So I'm going to go for my audio file or my sound file or my voice file, whatever. And then I'm going to click on SBAT_204, that's the name of my sound file, and click on open. I'm going to set my volume to 70, and then I'm going to leave the pitch at a default pitch, which is 1, and click on OK. So with this, I have my sound file added to that of my player or character. Go ahead and launch my game. Now, whenever my character collides with the, I have this hello, or the voice trigger, which is hello. Collides and you have a hello. So this is how to trigger a sound. This is how to add a sound file to that of your character and give your character a voice. Hello. Thank you very much for watching. In my next video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to share with you how to create a dress-up game. So you can click on the subscribe button or also click on the notification. That way, whenever I release my next video, you can be the first person to have it and then create your dress-up game. Thank you very much and bye.